once again. Today we are looking at day four of the final week of the life of Jesus here on earth. And this would be Wednesday of that week. This is the day that the Bible tells us very, very little about. It doesn't really say what the Lord did on Wednesday of Passion Week. There's lots of speculations, and of course you could read commentaries and get input from several individuals on what might have happened after he spent two exhausting days in Jerusalem. As he had already overturned the tables of the temple, as he was already teaching about how not to be a hypocrite and how we are to be pure on the inside. We know that Jesus and his disciples spent this day resting in anticipation of the upcoming Passover. He was probably in Bethany, which was about 2 miles east of Jerusalem. And here, Lazarus and his sisters, Mary and Martha, were also living. And we've talked about Mary and Martha in our previous devotional time. We know that these were very close friends of Jesus. And this is the same Lazarus which Jesus raised from the dead. And they probably hosted him and his disciples during these final few days. A short time previously, Jesus had shared with his disciples and the world that he had the power over death when he raised Lazarus from the dead. So that was already shown to those he would have been spending this time with. And after seeing this incredible miracle, I can't even imagine what it would look like to actually visually see Jesus raise someone from the grave. But there were many people after that time that believed that Jesus was the Son of God, and they put their full faith in him. They also, in Bethany, just a few nights earlier, Lazarus' sister Mary had lovingly anointed the feet of Jesus with that very expensive perfume. So we don't know exactly what all they did on this Wednesday. We can put pieces together and we can kind of speculate. But isn't it amazing how our Lord and Savior spent those final few days with his dearest friends and closest followers? How he completely took time to just be present with them. My challenge to you this week is to be present. To be present with those who mean the most to you. And most importantly, be present. Be present with our Lord and Savior. God bless.